Hello everyone. In this lecture, you will learn about what is mean by Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation and how to solve such type of differential equations. Okay. Basically, Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation, it is linear differential equation. It is in the form of linear differential equation with variable coefficients. So we will use some substitution and we will transform it into linear differential equation with constant coefficients. And once we get constant coefficients, then find out complementary function and particular integral with the help of our usual methods. Okay. So first of all, I will explain about how to identify that given differential equation is Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation. And once we notice that it is in this form, then we will use substitution. We will transform it into LD, linear differential equation with constant coefficient, then get the complementary function and particular integral, and finally solutions. Now first of all, I state the format of this Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation. A differential equation of the type a naught x raised to n into d raised to n y by dx raised to n plus a1 x raised to power n minus 1 d raised to power n minus y upon dx raised to power n minus 1. You continue in this way. So some constant into x raised to n. So here x raised to n is attached with nth derivative. In the second term, n minus 1th derivative is there. And what is the power of x here? It is x raised to power n minus 1. So if I continue in this way, so you will get an minus 1 into x into dy by dx. And finally plus an y is equal to f of x. So this is the form of standard form of Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation. How to identify this? If x is attached with dy by dx, or x square is attached with d square y by dx square, and so on. So nth derivative x raised to n, it is multiplied by x raised to n. So for example, x square into d square y by dx square plus 5x into dy by dx plus 7y is equal to some function on the right hand side, f of x. So this is the form of, this is what example of Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation. Why? Because x is attached with dy by dx. X square is attached with d square y by dx square. So basically, this is linear differential equation with variable coefficients. Okay, what are the coefficients? A naught x raised to n. It is not constant. A1 x raised to n minus 1. So these are the coefficients of what? Derivatives and dependent variable. So first of all, we will use some appropriate substitution and transform this differential equation with into what? Linear differential equation with constant coefficients. And once we get constant coefficients, we will determine complementary function and particular integral, and finally its general solution. Okay, so what is the required substitution to transform this into LD with constant coefficient? So I erase this part. Now put x is equal to e to the power z. It is very important substitution as far as this differential equation is concerned. Put x is equal to e to the power z. So therefore, z is equal to log x. Z is equal to log x. Now write the expression for dy by dx. So I write dy by dx as dy by dz into dz by dx. See, we have changed the independent variable. Here independent variable is x. Now we will transform this into what? Z. So what is expression for dy by dx? It is dy by dz into dz by dx. Now is equal to dy by dz. Now what is dz by dx? So z is equal to log x. So differentiation of z with respect to what? X. It is simply 1 by x. It means, therefore, this implies x into dy by dx is equal to dy by dz. And this is, let us say that, is equal to capital dy. Now, in this case, please assume that capital D stands for derivative with respect to z. Capital D stands d by dz. Now, we have replaced or we have got the expression x into dy by dx is equal to dy. Now, we will proceed towards what? Second order derivative. So, therefore, x into dy by dx is equal to dy. And what I have said that capital D stands dy dz operator. Now, d square y by dx square is equal to d by dx of dy by dx. Right? So, what is dy by dx? Dy by dx is here 1 by x into dy by dz. Okay? So, differentiate this. Now, first function as it is, differentiation of second. See how I take the differentiation of second part. So, I will write d by dx as d by dz of dy by dz into dz by dx. Okay? See, this step is very important. I have used differentiation of composite function. So, d by dx of this first function as it is, what is differentiation of dy by dz? It is d by dz of dy by dz into dz by dx plus dy by dz as it is into differentiation of 1 by x, that is minus 1 by x square. Now, simplify this expression. So, here is 1 by x and what is dz by dx? As per our substitution, z is log x. So, dz by dx is 1 by x. So, this is 1 by x, this is 1 by x. So, it is 1 by x square. And d by dz of this, so it is d square y by dz square minus 1 by x square into dy by dz. Now, multiply throughout this expression by x square. So, therefore, x square into d square y by dx square is equal to, now in capital D, it will be written as d square y minus dy, that is d into d minus 1 into y. Now, look at this expression. X into dy by dx is equal to d into y, capital D into y. What about this? X square into d square y by dx square is equal to d into d minus 1 into y. So, similarly, we can show that x cube into d cube y by dx cube is equal to d into, one can easily guess, d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 into y. So, similarly, we can write the expression for higher order derivatives. So, what is for nth order derivative? So, x raised to n into d raised to n y by dx raised to n is equal to, now is equal to d d minus 1 d minus 2. You continue in this way. If here is third order derivative, then here is 2. So, here is nth order derivative, I have to write n minus 1. So, d minus n minus 1 into y. So, when I use this substitution, x is equal to e to the power z. So, I have to replace this by this. Then, second order derivative by d into d minus 1 into y. Third order derivative. It means, we have transformed the given differential equation into linear differential equation with constant coefficients. And once it is transformed into LD with constant coefficients, we can easily find out its complementary function and particular integral. So please remember that these substitutions, they are very important. I have written here x square into d square y by dx square is equal to d into d minus 1 into y. So these substitutions or these replacements, they are very important. This one, this one, this one, and this is the last one. Now we will solve the example based on Euler's or Cauchy's differential equation. So first example, solve the differential equation. Solve the following differential equation. X square into d square y by dx square minus 3x into dy by dx plus 5y is equal to x square into sine of log x. X square into sine of log x. Now look at this differential equation. Okay. So first of all, make sure that it is not LD with constant coefficients, because coefficients, they are not here constant. Here is 5, but here is 3x and here is x square. So therefore, this is not LD with constant coefficient. Moreover, x is attached with dy by dx. Then x square is attached with d square y by ds square. It means it is second order Euler's or Cauchy's linear differential equation. Okay, so let us proceed. How to find out its solution? So solution part. So this is, first of all, I have to mention that this is Euler's differential equation. It is Euler's differential equation. So once we recognize that it is Euler's differential equation, our substitution is put x is equal to e to the power z. So therefore, automatically z becomes log x. Now replace, now I write here, replace x into dy by dx by dy, where this capital D stands d by dz. Why? As per our earlier explanation. Then second order derivative, d square y by dx square, you replace it by d into d minus 1 into y. Okay, since it involves second order derivative. So under this substitution, this differential equation will take the form. Now this d into d minus 1 into y minus 3 x into dy by dx. It is dy plus 5y is equal to, now remember that here d stands d by dz. So we have changed the independent variable. It means I have to change the function on the right hand side also. So write this function in terms of z. You use this substitution. So what is x square? X is e to the power z. It means x square is e to the power 2z. And what is sine of log x? It is sine of log x is here z. So write in simplified form. So d square d into d minus 1. D square minus d minus 3d. So d square minus 4d plus 5 into y is equal to e to the power 2z into sin z. Now we have transformed the given differential equation into what? Linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Now what are the coefficients of y or dy by dz or d square by dz square? They are constant. Now remaining part is as usual to get the complementary function and particular integral. So first of all, we will calculate complementary function. So what is auxiliary equation? Auxiliary equation is here m square minus 4m plus 5 is equal to 0. So what about the roots of this quadratic equation? I think you will get imaginary roots. So m is equal to minus b. So 4 plus minus root b square 16 minus 4 a into c, that is 1 into 5 divided by 2. So roots are 2 plus minus 16 minus 20. So minus 4 square root of minus 4, that is 2i. So 2i divided by 2, that is 2 plus minus r. So roots are complex. So write the complementary function. Now I write here y suffix c is equal to complementary function. Now is equal to e to the power 2z. Please remember that most of the students, they write this solution as e to the power 2x into bracket c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. It is totally wrong. Okay? Because this is the differential equation where independent variable is z. So do remember that, don't write this solution in terms of x directly. You have to write in terms of z first and then transform into x. So what I have to write then here, e to the power 2z c1 cos z plus c2 sin z. Please note down, this is very important step. Because in a hurry students, they might write here e to the power 2x c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. So your solution, it should be first in terms of z and then in terms of x. At the end, I will write this in terms of x. Now let us proceed towards the particular integral. So particular integral is equal to 1 upon, now what is this operator, d square minus 4d plus 5 e to the power 2z into sin of z. Okay. Now this is in the form of e to the power ax into v. Please recall exponential shift case number 4, e to the power ax into v. So write e to the power 2z to the left of this operator and replace d by d plus 2. I write here d by d plus 2. So d plus 2 whole square minus 4d plus 2 plus 5 operated on sin z. So y suffix p, that is particular integral, is equal to e to the power 2z upon 1 upon, now simplify this expression, d square plus 4d and minus 4d, it will cancel. So d square plus 4d minus 4d will cancel. So here is plus 4 plus 4 minus 8 plus 5. So what is this? 9 minus 8, that is 1. So d square plus 1 operated on sin z. So e to the power 2z. Now this is second case, trigonometric case. Replace d square by minus a square. What is a here? A is 1. So replace d square by minus 1. It is a case of failure. So multiply it by z upon differentiation. So 2d sin z. Remember that multiplied by z here, not x. So it is z by 2 e to the power 2z. What is integration of sin z? So it is minus cos z. So minus cos z. So this is your particular integral. Now final solution is, now I write final solution. Here e to the power 2z is there. So therefore, general solution is y is equal to y suffix c, complementary function plus particular integral. So e to the power 2z, you recall or you remember this substitution, x is equal to e to the power z. So what is e to the power 2z? It is x square into c1 cos of, what is z? Z is log x plus c2 sin of log x. C2 sin of log x. And what about particular integral? Minus z by 2. So minus z is equal to log x. So 1 by 2 e to the power 2z, that is x square log x into cos of z. So cos of log x. So complementary function plus particular integral, it gives the complete solution. So this is the solution of given differential equation. And remember that it should be in terms of x, that is y as a function of x. So wherever z is there, you remove that z with the help of this substitution. Thank you for watching this video.